this is my presentation, Future Education, Millennials Perspective. I think that the education systems should have mainly two goals. At the national level, they should contribute in the making of more just societies, whilst at the international level, they should be able to raise individuals who are able to feel empathy, to communicate and to cooperate, and to comprehend also the complexity of the globalized world we are living in today. One of the main problems with many educational systems, I think, lies in the fact that they are mainly based on knowledge, which is obviously essential, but it is not sufficient anymore, and it has probably never been sufficient. It is about time we start to focus also on soft skills, because through these skills, and we will analyze a few of them during this presentation, students can become actually able to build up cooperation and more just societies. Another problem with school systems is that they do not really take into account one of the main human characteristics, which is diversity. Still, we assess students according to standardized tests, and still we expect them to realize themselves according to standardized models of success. What does it happen when a student fails to fit into these models? He starts to believe to be an intelligent when that is not really the case. We should focus more on the student intended as the single person in order to understand who she really is, what her potentialities are, and help her build them up so that she can gain self-esteem and achieve actual self-realization. Another problem, in my opinion, with today's liberal societies is that they are mainly based on negative freedom, which is obviously very much needed, but at the same time, negative freedom has created an atomized society in which a culture of competition and individualism has spread. We should start to try to achieve social freedom, which is based on mutual recognition and cooperation. So let's try to make students understand that they can still achieve their common and personal goals by cooperating with each other rather than competing. And talking about soft skills, we have communication skills and critical thinking, creativity and environmental awareness. Talking about the communication skills, I am a millennial, so I am obviously going to talk about social media, but now I have a quiz for you. Who do you think is the author of this quote? "We have come 5,000 miles to tell the UN and the world that you must change your ways. I am fighting for my future. Losing my future is not like losing election or few points on the stock market. Pay attention because I will give you a grade, and if you fail, you will be marked for life." Any attempt?
Greta.
That's right. This was Greta Thunberg during her last speech at the United Nations. But this is actually fake news, because the author of this quote is Severn Callis Suzuki.
Yes, 1992.
Yeah, exactly. She was an environmental activist. She was 12 years old back in the 90s. And what's the difference? Why did I play this joke? What's the difference between these two activists? One of the main is the fact that Greta Thunberg has the social media, and she's been able to use them in the best way possible, because through Instagram, through Facebook, she's been able to educate millions of people, to make them aware of the climate change problem, and to gather their energies in the environmental protection battle. But social media are not good nor bad in absolute terms. They're just an instrument, and they can be used for good or bad purposes. On the one hand, you have Greta Thunberg. On the other one hand, you have disruptive political forces who collect your personal data and spread fake news in order to affect their capacity to make decisions according to clear evidence. Just think of what happened in Britain, in UK. And this is why critical thinking is very important. We gotta make students able to tell fake news from real news, and one way should be teach them how to do proper research. And believe me, even in my university, many people, many students have no idea how to tell a scientific article from a newspaper article. So how can they tell real news from fake news? And this is very important. And let's teach them how to use social media, because social media can even lead to dissociation and depersonalization. So let's make them understand how to use this properly. And it is also very important that we start to make them develop cultural competencies in communications, because today we are facing global problems that need a global action, a global response. But in order to achieve that, we need to communicate better. And I suggest to mandatory anthropology courses everywhere, at all levels, from primary school, secondary school, high school, because anthropology really teaches you to understand everyone's perspective, which doesn't mean accept their perspective, but it is functional to boost the cooperation capacities of people. Talking about creativity, there are many researchers that show evidence of how school systems tend to kill creativity, and this is a huge problem, because through making students creative, we will be able to make them able to find creative solutions to the problems they are facing, we are facing today, and that we will be facing in the future. And another problem is that school systems tend to teach students how to adapt to the world, how to survive in the world. It is time that by being creative, students learn how to imagine new mind-blowing possibilities for a better future. And this is, to end up, a very popular argument, environmental awareness. I think that today's economic culture is mainly based on profit, when it should be based on human needs. We gotta change this culture. We gotta teach students that money doesn't really care. They are a tool and not an end in itself. Spirit is more important than matter, and every person's behavior actually affects the environment. So let's teach them how to be environmentally responsible, so that we will boost our capacities to survive as a species in this world. This was my presentation. Thank you for your attention. And follow me on Instagram at